Hi everyone, today we're going to take a look at the new constraints feature inside of Fusion. To demonstrate how it works, we're going to assemble this air fryer drawer. Let's start by launching the constraints command directly from the toolbar.
Constraints let us describe relationships between components by building up individual pairings of geometry.
This allows you to describe complex relationships broken down into simple constraints. The first constraint I'm going to create is between the cylindrical face on the drawer outer and this edge on the drawer inner. There are still degrees of freedom remaining. So next, I'll add another row to the table and build up a second constraint. I'll select the cylinder and the edge on the opposite side to continue to bring their components into their finished position. Finally, I need to position this correctly in Z. I can quickly use the heads-up display to make a new line in the table, and I'll choose the edge and the top face while also applying an offset of 0.5mm. Now that I've built up my full set of constraints, let's go ahead and hit OK. You can now see that those three constraints have been grouped together to make one entity in the timeline. In the browser, you have the constraint set group, but can also expand to see the individual constraints if required. Next, we'll connect the drawer inner to the basket. To start, I'm going to align the bolt holes by choosing the cylinders. This keeps them concentric while still allowing movement along their axis. Again, quickly adding another constraint, I'll select the other two bolt holes to bring this rotationally correct. Now I'm going to align the face of the drawer inner with the outer face of the basket. One thing to note here is my previous constraint set between the drawer outer and inner is still being honored in the preview. That's controlled by a preference that's on by default, but you can turn it on or off as needed. This now means when assembling multiple components, you get to see the full result in the preview. Let's assemble the handle. For more complex geometry, like this snap fit, it's not always practical to use the exact model faces, as this component is actually designed to have interference and flex when it's fitted together. That's where construction planes become really useful. I'll create a constraint between these construction planes, and again, using the heads-up display to quickly add new rows to the table and make my selections. Let's now press OK. As I move the part around, I notice there is still a degree of freedom left to define. So let's edit that constraint set and constrain the bottom of the handle to the drawer inner. Something to highlight here is that we've just gone from one component, the handle, to multiple others. It started with the construction planes on the drawer outer, and we actually ended with a face on the drawer inner. This is a great example of how constraints let you build up one to many relationships between components. That gives you far more flexibility and control in your assemblies, especially when things depend upon other geometries from more than one part. And there we go. We've fully assembled our air fryer drawer using constraints in Fusion. This is just our first release of constraints, and we're already working on how to expand its capabilities. Stay tuned for more updates, keep an eye out for upcoming tutorials, and we're going to continue to make assemblies in Fusion faster, more powerful, and more intuitive. Thanks for watching, and happy modeling.